ever dreamed for an AI assistant right in your terminal assisting you in every keystroke? Well, get ready because today we are embarking on a journey through the expensive landscape of Shell GPT. So this is Emersek, go get your coffee ready and just dive in. This is going to be cool. Before doing anything, what you will need to use Shell GPT? You will need any Linux machine such as Kali Linux, Ubuntu, BartOS, or whatever you like, and ChatGPT 4 API. And that's it, that's all you need. All right, let's kick things off with the installation process. Simply go to your Kali machine. I will zoom a little bit here. So right now to install ChatGPT, you have to make sure that you have Python 3. If you don't have it, just type sudo apt install Python 3-y and hit enter. Kali. Actually, I have it installed, so just clear the screen. After that, to install ChatGPT, it's just a piece of cake. Type pip install and chill-gpt and hit enter. Wait a couple of seconds and it will be installed with you exactly like that. Clear the screen. So after installing ChatGPT, what you have to do is simply type sgpt and hit enter. Is going to ask you for your ChatGPT API key and you will paste it and that's it. Like that, you will be configured your Shell GPT. So I have it actually configured, so I will clear my screen. So let's get down with the business a little bit. Shell GPT is not just a tool, it's like your coding buddy who always know the answer for your question. Check this. Right now if I typed sgpt and I'll tell him what is AI in two words? Okay, two words. And like that, as you can see, it's told me like it's artificial intelligence. Okay, so it's not just about chatting, it's about having a conversation with your terminal. So what about boosting a data using curl? So right here I will type echo. Right here I need to add my data first, so I will type here and type name, and like that it's going to be Emer and the age it's going to be 17, right? Okay, and I'll close that and single quotation. Simply what's going to do is asking ChatGPT for giving me the command that I will use it to post this data. So I will type sgpt dash dash shell and I will tell him what I'm doing. Like I want like create user using curl, like that, and hit enter. And as you can see, it simply gave me the command that I will use for posting the data. It gave me curl dash x post dash h and here is the header, and dash d for the data and the URL for doing it. And here it's giving me three options: execute or describe or abort. So actually what I'm going to do right now is abort it like that and clear my screen again. Now this is where it gets seriously cool. Right now ChatGPT is not just doing that, it's doing a lot more. You can ask him simply to give you any code you want using sgpt dash dash code argument and he will give you the code complete. But wait, there is more. ChatGPT introduces chat mode. It's like having a chill conversation with your terminal. Look at that. Sgpt dash dash chat and it's going to be chat 2. Like I will call my shell like that and I will tell him, remember my age, it's 17. Okay, it's 17. And I will close that and I'll hit enter. And as you can see, it's told me understand blah blah blah, he will remember my age. So right here if I type sgpt dash dash chat 2 for my previous chat and I will ask him, how old am I? Close that. And as you can see, it's told me like I'm 17 years old. But actually, if that's all, there is more. So right here, what if there is like a command I cannot remember? Actually, I will type sgbt dash dash shell and ask him what I'm going to do, like check my disk space, okay, and simply hit enter. It actually gave you the command that you will use, and I will hit E to execute it, and as you can see, here is my disk. Actually, there is more and more and more for shell GPT. I cannot cover all the usage in one quick tutorial, so you can check my article link down in description. You will find every command for shell GPT, or you can take a look on the GitHub page. Everything is there, and there is no problem with it. Alright guys, shell GPT is not just a tool. It's like your coding buddy who makes your terminal a magic place. Tweak it to your liking and let the command line productivity party begin. Actually, this is all I got. Do not forget to hit subscribe and smash that like button and ring that notification bell. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below, or you can reach me directly using Twitter. Until then, stay curious and stay secure.